Hi, I am Vipin Khanolkar, Sales Strategist and your host of CafeScientia. CafeScientia believes in science of business and entrepreneurship. Our aim is to provide you scientific concepts and frameworks to grow your business and sales. Most of the time, I see startups come up with excellent product, excellent service and platform, but could not perform well due to lack of customer acquisition and due to lack of proper analysis of customer acquisition technique. I think you are also facing same question in your startup and business. At early stage, we are provided with limited funds for marketing. Most of the investment is already get absorbed in product research and development. So I am going to discuss some extremely low budget customer acquisition techniques that you can apply in your startup or business. I will also provide its mathematical analysis part. But before customer acquisition, I hope you are clear about two things. Who are your target customer and where are your target customers? So first one is leveraging personal network. Here you can use your personal contacts and find customer. Think for your friends, family members, colleagues who can help you in this. Next one is about social media engagement. Use social media like Facebook, Twitter, Quora, Instagram. Join communities, develop pages and provide content. Try to engage people and then also provide information about your product and services. Next one is about cold contacts. Explore social media, different websites, blogs. Try to find contact details of your potential customers. Then you can call them or email them and provide information about your product and services and then set an appointment with them. Now next one is influencers. Influencers are those who has great fan following and huge personal network. Find such influencers and ask them to share about your product and services in their personal network. Next one is think win-win. This is most important. Actually, while reading the book 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, I thought how startups can apply this habit think win-win to grow their potential customers. So think win-win is actually about complementary services. Suppose you have DJ services, then you can actually join with some event management company, decoration services or celebration halls. Suppose you have interior designing startup, then you can join with some construction company. Suppose you have car washing startup, then you can join with automobile services and automobile spare parts shop also. The idea behind this is to think for complementary work related to your product and services, then share your customer. So this is what actually about think win-win. This is what about very less expensive customer acquisition technique. But if you have good budget, then you can go for paid social media ads, paid YouTube ads, banners, stickers and others also. So use customer acquisition techniques according to your product, your services and kind of solutions you are offering. Now I will explain you about the mathematical analysis of customer acquisition technique. Most of the time, startups choose wrong customer acquisition technique and outspend their money. So for mathematical analysis, you have to calculate two things. First one is customer acquisition cost. Customer acquisition cost is total expenditure you have done to acquire one customer. It can be calculated by simple formula like CAC equals to total expenditure on sales and marketing divided by number of customers acquired in same time period. Suppose you have used social media ads as your customer acquisition technique and you have spent about 50,000 rupees for 3 months to acquire new customers. And in these 3 months, you acquired 100 new customers. So customer acquisition cost can be calculated as 50,000 plus 5000 is, let's say, your other expenditure upon number of new customers you have acquired, that is 100. So CAC equals to 550 rupees. Next one is lifetime value. Lifetime value is how much the customer worth to me, or total revenue expected from single customer over the lifetime of their purchase. But calculating lifetime value is not so easy, because first we need to establish lifetime of customer. It is so dynamic and it is always difficult to predict how much time the customer remains loyal to you. So here I want to give you simple formula. Lifetime value is equals to average amount of purchase by one customer multiplied by number of repeatable purchases. Let's say average amount of purchase by one customer is rupees 300 and number of repeatable purchases are 9. So lifetime value comes 2700 rupees. After calculation of customer acquisition cost and lifetime value, you need to compare both. If lifetime value is greater than equals to 3 times customer acquisition cost, then it is beneficial for your startup. And if not, then either you have to raise the prices of your product or services, or you have to reduce cost, or also you can go for any other customer acquisition technique. So here is simple framework that you can use to analyze correct customer acquisition technique. Just note down the techniques or the combination of correct customer acquisition techniques that you are using. Find out customer acquisition cost and then compare it with LTV. LTV is same for all techniques. So here you can analyze which technique is working better for you, because to grow sales, you have to focus on correct customer acquisition technique. This is all about how startups can acquire new customers at early stage. So please subscribe to our channel to stay updated with new scientific strategies and frameworks that you can apply in your business and startup. And if you want our team to work with you regarding sales strategies, so please contact us at hello@capacentia.com. Thank you.